In this video, we're going to have a look at the new accessibility feature on iOS 17 called Assistive Access. This is a feature that will completely change how your device looks and how your device works, and it has real benefits for a lot of people. So we're going to jump into the Settings app and then go on to Accessibility. From here towards the bottom of that page is a section for General, and in here you have Assistive Access. I'm going to tap onto there now. There are a couple of little steps to go through to begin with, and one of which is to choose how you want your phone layout to look. So basically, what this feature is going to do, it's going to greatly simplify your iPhone experience, going to remove all of the clutter, all of the things that perhaps might get in the way, and strip it back to the real essentials. You can choose if you want to have this done as a row, so one after another vertically, or if you want a grid of large icons, perhaps more akin to a normal iPhone home screen. Next up, we're going to choose what apps you're going to have access to in this new mode. Now, there are 5 apps that are currently optimized by Apple to work in a different way in Assistive Access. So phone, text, photos, music, and the camera. When you press the green plus button next to these, you can actually get some more options to fine-tune what those apps can and can't do. For example, can they access location data? Do you want them to access all your photos? Those sort of things. And some of the apps have got controls as well that you can enable or disable. So for example, the camera, you can disable selfie mode, or you can disable video, or you can enable one mode, not the other. You can really fine tune what you're going to have access to or not when this setting is enabled. Now, underneath these 5 apps are all the other apps currently on your iPhone. Now, any of these apps can be added to Assistive Access, but they won't work in the same simplified way that those 5 core apps do. I'm wondering if perhaps in the future Apple might update more apps to be more simplified for this very reason. I'm going to jump down and just add the Clips app, for example, just to kind of show you how that works in this mode as well. And you can see I've got a lot of different permissions here to grant, so I'm going to very quickly go through and do that. And now I'm happy that I've got the app selected. I'm going to press Continue at the bottom, and we're going to get a little bit more information about Assistive Access. You can disable it at any time by pressing the lock button 3 times, and you're going to put in a PIN code to make sure it's protected. The next step is setting up that PIN code. I'll do that very quickly now. And then all that's left to do is to enable Assistive Access. Your screen will go black for a moment or two while it reloads, and then you're going to see this. Straight away, you're going to see your iPhone looks very, very different. A lot more simple, no wallpapers, no animations, and I can simply tap that nice big button to unlock my phone. Then I'm presented with the app launcher, and I've got those 6 apps that I've just chosen. If I go into the phone app, for example, again, it's going to look very different to the phone app that you're probably used to having already. From here, I can quickly access key contacts, and I can make a phone call just like normal, but again, it just looks slightly simplified. And this simplified approach carries across to all 5 of those apps. For example, the Photos app here, I haven't got all the toolbars and menus and back buttons. I've just got my camera roll, and I can explore those photos just like this. If I just go into camera as well, you can see here I've got the option for a photo or a video. Very simply labeled, nice big graphics, and when I tap onto one, I can then simply take a photo or record a video. All of these symbols, the colours, the graphics, they're designed to really stand out and to make your device more accessible than ever before. Now, if I go into the Clips app, which you might remember isn't optimised for this mode, you'll see that it looks more or less the same as normal, with the addition of that nice big back button at the bottom. That means you can still use all the features of this particular app, but it isn't going to have that reduced interface like the other ones do. So it depends on perhaps who the device is for and what you want to have access to, as to whether or not you want to enable other apps besides those key 5. And then when you're finished with Assistive Access, you're going to tap the lock button 3 times, type in your PIN code, and wait for your device to restart. And just like that, we're back on the original iPhone with iOS 17 running as normal. Assistive Access is always just 3 taps away on that lock button, and you can then customize how it works a bit more once you've had a chance to explore it. It is an incredibly powerful feature that genuinely completely changes how your iPhone works. And I think actually we should give full credit to Apple for making this mode in the first place. It's clearly taken a lot of designing work, a lot of coding work to make this come to life, but it makes that device so much more accessible for a huge amount of people. So Apple, well done for this new feature. I think it's fantastic. And there are loads more things in iOS 17 that are new as well. If you want to check some out, there's a playlist at the end here for you now. And don't forget, if you like this video, please do subscribe to my channel down below. That way you won't miss any videos in the future.